Here is the train to Glasgow. And here is the driver, Mr. MacIver, who drove the train to Glasgow. And here is the guard from Donibristle, who waved his flag and blew his whistle to tell the driver, Mr. MacIver, to start the train to Glasgow. Here is a boy called Donald McBrain, who came to the station to catch the train, and saw the guard from Donibristle wave his flag and blow his whistle to tell the driver, Mr. MacIver, to start the train to Glasgow. And here is a guard, a kindly man, who at the last moment hauled into the van that fortunate boy called Donald McBrain, who came to the station to catch the train, and saw the guard from Donibristle wave his flag and blow his whistle to tell the driver, Mr. MacIver, to start the train to Glasgow. Here are the hens and here are the cocks, clucking and crowing inside a box, in charge of the guard, that kindly man, who at the last moment hauled into the van that fortunate boy called Donald McBrain, who came to the station to catch the train, and saw the guard from Donibristle wave his flag and blow his whistle to tell the driver, Mr. MacIver, to start the train to Glasgow. Here is a train which gave a jolt, and loosened a catch and loosened a bolt, let out the hens and let out the cocks, clucking and crowing out of their box, in charge of the guard, that kindly man, who at the last moment hauled into the van that fortunate boy called Donald McBrain, who came to the station to catch the train, and saw the guard from Donibristle wave his flag and blow his whistle to tell the driver, Mr. MacIver, to start the train to Glasgow. The guard chased a hen and missing it fell. The hens were clucking, the cocks as well. Unless you were there, you haven't a notion the flurry, the fuss, the noise, the commotion caused by the train which gave a jolt and loosened a catch and loosened a bolt, let out the hens and let out the cocks, clucking and crowing out of their box, in charge of the guard, that kindly man, who at the last moment hauled into the van that fortunate boy called Donald McBrain, who came to the station to catch the train, and saw the guard from Donibristle wave his flag and blow his whistle to tell the driver, Mr. MacIver, to start the train to Glasgow. Now Donald was quick and Donald was neat, and Donald was nimble on his feet. He caught the hens and he caught the cocks, and he put them back in their great big box. The guard was pleased as pleased could be. He invited Donald to come to tea on Saturday at Donibristle, and he'd let him blow his lovely whistle. He said in all his life he'd never seen a boy so quick and clever, and so did the driver, Mr. MacIver, who drove the train to Glasgow.